out there, you guys. Marty here from GuitarJams.com. Gonna teach you a little acoustic version of this song here. Super easy beginner version. And if you are a beginner, I've got a great ebook down there that you can just sign my my request list down there, and I'll send you an ebook that has the beginner chords and the scales that will help with all these video lessons. Okay, so the first thing I did was I put what's called a capo on the second fret, right there. And then here's some great chords that you're gonna wanna know for a million songs. The first chord is called E minor, and it's usually the first chord I teach a beginner. A lot of you know it already, but so basically if this is the zero fret now, then we go to the second fret of the A string and the second fret of the D string. And you strum the whole thing. Now for this chord sequence, I think it's going to be better that we use our middle finger on the A string here and our ring finger on the D string because of the next chord that we're going to get to. It'll be easier to switch to it. So right off the bat, we've got E minor. And I'll show you some, rhythm to work on. So we've got E minor. Then we're going to take our ring finger and we're going to put on the third fret of the A string. Middle finger on the second fret of the D, and then the open G, and then first fret on the B, and that's called a C chord. So we play that next. Then the last chord, and this is the whole song, is a G chord. And so we take our middle finger, and we're gonna put it on the third fret of this top string here, second fret of the next one. And then ring finger on the third fret of the high E. G chord. And these are just great to practice too, like. You know, just mixing them around. Okay, so the amount of time the chords take up. We're gonna take this E minor chord, we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4. We're gonna subdivide it with some strums, and then only two on C. 1, 2, and then two on G. 3, 4, so we got 1. GuitarJams.com. This is Marty speaking. All right, where were we? So we've got the E minor, the C, and the G. And I like that one. I teach that one a lot, but if you can get good at that one, then and you get it second nature, then you can vary it. So we're gonna go down, 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 up, up. Down, 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 up, up. Down, 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 up, up. Down, 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 up, 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 down, up, down, up. So it just, and you add up, down, up to what we just did. Down, 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 up, up. Take two on that. So that rhythm pattern holds the entire time for the E minor, and then the C and G split it in half, karate chop style. So we got. So that first up of the sequence is when it switches to the G. Minor. you get the idea. So here's the rhythm sequence, a little bit slow, so you can practice along. So once again, I'm Marty with GuitarJams.com. I've got that free ebook that you can sign up for, plus a website, you know, with a ton of lessons on it that you can always try out for free for 3 days. And yeah, like hearing from you, and all the support is awesome. Hope you had fun with it, and got more coming. We'll see you guys later.